Welcome to part two of how to make this adventure-style base map in ArcGIS Online. In part one, I showed you how to use the vector tile style editor to create a texture layer to scrape some charming lived-in reality into your maps. In part two, I'm going to focus on assembling these assets in the map viewer with a couple trips to the vector tile style editor to get just what we need. Making a big custom base map like this is pretty straightforward, but it's also a lot of fun, whether you're making your own layers, harvesting them from Living Atlas, or a little bit of both. Let's dive in to part two. I'll open up the base map menu and Topographic is selected by default. I'll dig into this and I can turn off these base map layer elements just to see what we've got. I'll get rid of this main layer, the world topographic map tile layer, remove, and I'm actually going to keep the world hillshade, but I'll add another hillshade layer, this one the generalized bathymetry and hillshade layer from Living Atlas. It's a hillshade and elevation tint layer that has like an old school airbrushed vibe. Next, I'll make this map nitty gritty and lived in. So I'll search Living Atlas for texture and I'll add parchment, and if I scroll down, ooh, this is familiar, that's that cement texture I made in the previous video. I called it slate. I'm gonna give this cementy slaty texture a color burn blend mode to bring out the rich golden tones of that parchment underneath it, and that's good, but it's not quite enough. So I'll select that parchment texture and give it an effect of saturate and really crank it up. Next, I'm gonna call in from Living Atlas a water layer, and it's gonna do the heavy lifting of this base map. It's called bathymetry light and it looks about exactly how you might expect. And so I can reclaim some of that oceanic texture from before, I'm gonna give it a blend mode of multiply. Okay, now I'm gonna show you a trick to give your coasts a faded tint. With that bathymetry light layer active, I'll give it a drop shadow in a nice sandy color, and we get like a nice little fuzzy beachy effect on all of our coasts. Remember that beautiful water texture we made in the last video? Let's add this to our map. After all, that's why I made it. And I'll blend this water texture in with the blend mode of hard light, and I'll zoom and pan throughout the process to get a sense for colors and textures, and I like where this is headed. And I'll notice that even though I kept that original hillshade layer, I'm not seeing it because it's covered up by all the other ones. So I'm going to drag that original detailed world hillshade layer near the top, just under water texture, and then I'll give this a blend mode of color burn. So I currently have two hillshade layers, one generalized, and the world hillshade layer is more detailed, and they're both on at the same time. What I'd like to do is a handoff from one to the other at a certain zoom level. So I'll zoom around and find the zoom level where I'd like that tipping point to be, and then I'll adjust the visible range slider for my detailed world hillshade so that it's not visible when you're zoomed out, and then it switches on when you zoom in. And then for the generalized hillshade, I'll just set it for the exact opposite visibility range. And that's how you can make map viewers mutually exclusive based on zoom level. You see it here, you zoom in, and then you see the other one. But I'm going to take that one step further. I always want to see the generalized hillshade, but I want it to get more and more transparent as you zoom in. How do I do this? It's the same hack. I'll add that generalized hillshade layer a second time, and this one will switch on right when the other switches off, and this guy is going to be slightly transparent. And that's how you can switch layers or show different versions of a layer based on scale. But how are our adventurers even going to know where they are if they don't have a reference layer and labels? Now, I want to add a reference layer for borders and streets and houses and stuff like that, so I'm going to look up my favorite reference layer, human geography. Human geography dark detail. Oh boy, we have water in this though. That's kind of a showstopper, right? What can I do? Okay, well, I'll remove this, but it's also my chance to remind you that you're never stuck with the style and content of vector tile layers. You can change them using the vector tile style editor. So let me just pull in that human geography dark detail layer. I'll find the water layer and just bloop. Turn it off. And then I can just save this version of it without water. Human geography, dark detail, no water. This no water version is also available in Living Atlas. I'll add this to my map. I'll push its transparency back to 40% and I'll give it a blend mode of overlay. And I'll drag this reference layer up into the reference layer zone so that if anybody adds data to this map later, the reference will always float on top of that data. And I like how the overlay blend mode gives it a soft, almost watermark-like quality. And now I also need a labels layer, and I'm once again gonna go to the vector tile style editor. I really like the content of the world ocean reference labels, but I've styled them to look more like a mid-century 1940s shop manual. Bold sans serif font in crimsons and deep cyan, and I even give them all a slight rotation. I don't know, it just felt right. It's weird though. I called this labels layer adventure reference, and I didn't bother putting it into Living Atlas just because because it's a little odd. So you can find it just in regular old ArcGIS Online. And this one goes up in my reference layers too. And the result is the Adventure Map base map. I hope I've encouraged you to think creatively about how you can use base maps and tweak existing data layers that are available to you to suit your needs. Making your own base map with just the vibes that you need is such a rewarding experience. Almost as nice as taking a walk in the grass, flopping down on the ground, and letting the dappled sunlight brush against your face.